Hello everyone, this is Harshita Bhargav from Chitkara School of Hospitality, and in this session we are going to learn about expansion strategies of strategy formulation. In earlier session we have learned that there are various strategic alternatives available to a business organization, and expansion strategies is one among them. So we will learn about these expansion strategies, which are concentration strategies, integration strategies, diversification strategies, and cooperation strategies. We can say that these are the categories of expansion strategies. Let's first understand what do we mean by expansion strategies. So expansion strategies here means the business is planning to expand its business in terms of its products, services, and customers. In other words, corporate strategy of expansion is followed when an organization aims at higher growth and development by focusing upon one or more of its business in terms of customer functions, technologies, groups, singly or jointly, so that overall performance can be efficient and can be improved. Now it becomes imperative or necessary when the environment demands that we should, or a business should, increase its business activities or should increase its pace of business activities. Increasing size of a business may lead to more control over the market as compared to competitors, because by following expansion strategies, we are providing more products or more services to the customers in the market. So, it can lead to more control over the market as compared to the competitors. We can gain advantage from the experience curve, and scale of operations may accrue due to expansion. So, let's start with different expansion strategies. First is expansion through concentration. Concentration is a simple first level type of expansion strategy, which includes converging resources in one or more of a firm businesses in terms of their respective customer needs, customer functions, or alternative technologies, so that it would result in expansion. In other words, in concentration strategies, we are, or a business is, focusing its resources, its functions, and technologies towards their businesses in order to grow, develop, and expand. Concentration strategies involves an investment of resources in a product line for an identified market. That means a business is focusing upon particular product line as well as on identified or particular market segments. That's why it is called concentration strategies. Now this is INSOF product market matrix, which is very important and comes under concentration strategies of expansion. Now we can see here that the upper left hand side corner of this matrix is divided into two parts, and one part comprises product and the other part comprises market. That means when we will study the product aspects, we would study it horizontally in this manner, and when we will study markets, then markets would be studied vertically in this manner. That also means when we are focusing upon this box, that means we are talking about present products of the business in which a particular business is dealing, and we are focusing upon this box here. New is written. This means that we are talking about new products which a business or a company is going to launch soon. So this way we will study product. Similarly, for markets, when we are focusing upon present box, this means we are talking about those customer segments, those markets where our present customers are existing, or the customers who are buying our products and services lies there. When we are focusing upon new box, this means we are talking about new markets or target markets where we would sell our products and service. So in this manner, we will study products and markets. Products would be studied horizontally in this matrix, and markets would be studied vertically in this matrix. So when, if I see this column, which is market penetration, so when a company sells its present products to present markets, that means a business which is dealing in their particular products or services, when they sell their present products or present services to present customers or the identified customers of the business, then it would be called market penetration. On the other hand, when the same company sells its present or existing products and services to new markets, this would be called as market development. For example, let's say in 2019, company A is selling its products and services to Indian markets. Now, this company, which is A company, is planning to sell its product overseas or in overseas markets. Let's say this company wants to sell its product in UAE, United Arab Emirates, or in other Asian markets, including India. That means they are focusing upon new markets for selling their products and services. And please note here, they are selling only present products. They are not changing or modifying their products or services. They are selling their present products to new markets. Then this would be called as market development. Now if we go towards the other column, which talks about new products, that means other than the existing product lines and services, now company is planning to sell its new products or new product lines. And when they are selling new products to present markets, when they are selling new products to their existing customers or the present markets or the identified customers, then this would be called as product development. Now they are developing their products. For example, XYZ restaurant is providing food and beverage services to its customer. Now, this XYZ restaurant wants to diversify its business in jewelry. Now, they are planning to open up a jewelry showroom. So, this jewelry would be the new product for XYZ company, and it is selling that new product to the existing customers, to those customers who were coming to the XYZ restaurant earlier. So this would be called as product development. And when new products are sold to new markets, this would be called as diversification. That means a company has taken a totally new road to its business. They are launching new products, new services, and selling those new products and new services to new markets, to new customers. This would be called as diversification. So we have studied four terms here, which are market penetration, product development, market development, and diversification. So let's study these terms one by one. Market penetration involves selling more products to the same market. Let's say a firm is attempting to focus upon existing markets with its present products using a market penetration type of concentration. We have understood this thing with the help of that ENSOF product market matrix. Market development, which involves selling the same products to new markets, like I have given the example of new markets that a company is proposing to sell its new products and services to overseas market. So that company would try to attract new users for their existing products, which would result in market development. Product development, which includes selling new products to the same markets. Likewise, we have studied the example of restaurant and jewelry showroom, that in this strategy, company may introduce new products in the existing markets by concentrating on product development. In next session, we will learn about expansion through integration. Thanks for watching.